The other part is that I sit behind this desk, and that's the businessman.
Yes.
Okay. And a fight between me and the guy that sits on that bench over there, yes, is tremendous. I always say when I go buy pearls in Australia, and I'll sit there and I'll the first day I come and there's, oh God, this is great, great, oh my God. And then I come back the following day, the businessman comes back. Oh, all right, this I can afford, this I can't, I can do without this now. You know, and all of a sudden, comes down to what I really need. I really feel that God's given me a gift.
Yeah.
I really feel that. No education in design, but yet I see things. And there are times I do things. Where the heck does it come from? We had a pinch bottle that we made for Hake and Hake Scotch in pure gold, okay?
Yes.
Hollow. And we carved it all in wax, and everything was carved, and we started to put it all back together again. And then we put the neck on, and then the base was going to be put on, okay? But what I didn't calculate is when I would heat that up, that the neck wasn't big enough to let the heat out. So we got it nice and red, and I'm looking at it, and it's done, it's finished, okay? And just at that moment, the base was concave.
Yes.
It popped out, boom, just like that, just popped out. And I'm looking at it, I pick up a hammer, and whack it, and it must have been at the exact moment, because it went right in the way it should, and that was the end of it. What made me pick up that hammer? I'll never know to this day. One of the funniest things was making a chastity belt for a woman. The husband wanted it.
Yes.
And
as a joke, right?
No, I don't think so. And she would come in black leotards, and we would adjust it and measure it and fit it. And the hardest part was the lock. And then I had to make a diamond key.